Hi friends, in this video we will be discussing about anti-lock brake system ABS. This is an option, or you can say this is a feature which is introduced in new cars, or maybe little older cars this has been introduced, and this was not before. I mean to say, some decades before this system was not there in cars, but nowadays this is compulsory system in cars because ABS is a better braking system. In ABS system, the brakes are the wheels are not locked. Instead, they are rotating all the times while we are applying brakes. Even the wheels are rotating and they are catched by the brake pads or brake shoes. So this is what is the way how the ABS brake is working. Going towards this video, first you have to like this video, subscribe on my channel, press on bell icon so you will get notifications for each upload. For anti-lock brake system, here we will discuss its electrical system and all electrical components and schematic diagram I will show in this video. Component index is brake fluid level switch, brake switch, dash fuse box, data link connector DLC C34, 16 BLK, electronic brake control module EBCM, fuse relay box, left front ABS speed sensor, rear speed sensor, right front ABS speed sensor. These are the components which are used or which will be discussed in the schematic diagrams. So now we are proceeding towards the schematic diagrams of the system. So in the schematic diagram, as you can see, there are two powers have been given to this system, and also two grounds have been provided to the system. One is it seems to be a power ground, and the other seems to be the signal ground. So here this power is first, from here it is started hot at all times. It means that a wire is coming from the battery directly. There is no switch in between or nothing, no relay, but direct a wire is coming towards this fuse. And here is the ABS 60 ampere fuse in the fuse relay box in the engine compartment. As you can see, this is dotted, so it means that it is in the engine compartment, not engine compartment, but it is somewhere over in some other place. That's why it is dotted. So you can see here this power is applied, battery power is applied to this module, which we will discuss later in this video. And then another power which is hot and on while we are switching on the ignition switch. So that time a power is coming to this 15 amperes IG fuse, electric IG fuse. You can see this is in the dash fuse box. Dash fuse box is inside the passenger or the driver cabinet. So here this fuse box is shown. And then this power is also applied to the ABS computer or ABS module. And here this from this splice, this power is going to some other circuit, which we will discuss later in some other video, because here this is not discussed. Instead, only the ABS is discussed. So here is another thing, which is data link connector, data link connector DLC output. This is giving output to the DLC for reading or for viewing the system, how it is. And then class 2 serial data is also, it is connected, this pin is connected to the engine controls in 2.2 liter engine and 3.2 liter engine model. So this pin is on this pin, I mean to say, in the DLC connector, a computer or a scan tool is connected. And while we are making some changes in the system, or we are making repairs, or whatever, the brake pads are replaced or anything is made on the braking system, ABS system, then it is needed to be registered, those new pads, and adaptation is required. So that adaptation is done by this data link connector. So here these are, and the grounds as I discussed. So here two more things you can see: left front speed sensor, and the other is the right speed sensor, right front speed sensor. These two sensors are in both wheels. There are cogged wheels, which are, they are, sometimes they are on the axle, and sometimes they are the part of the wheel hub, somewhere they are. And then sensors are provided. These are the sensors actually, and this is shown as the cog wheels. So these sensors are taking samples from here. The pulses are introduced while the these cog wheels or wheels are moving or rotating. So pulses are introduced in these sensors, and these sensors are giving these pulses to the ABS computer or ABS module, and they are showing the position of the rotation. I mean to say, if the rotation is there, it will show, or if wheel is locking, so then it will also translate this locking position to the computer, and the computer will reduce the fluid level in that particular brake cylinder, and then by this way the wheel will not be locked and it will rotate again. So again it will catch the brake and it will try to the brake will try to restrict the motion, and while the motion is totally restricted, so this will be translated to the computer and computer will again release the brake. So this way the brake is releasing and attracting. This way the wheel is not locking and straight brake is applied, because the automotive engineers, they learned this scheme that if in any vehicle the wheels are locked, so the brake efficiency is down to zero and the brake efficiency will not be there and the vehicle will skid and it will slip and it will go in some accident. Something like that could happen, and this is happening. So by ABS system, this is eliminated. In ABS systems, the wheels are not locked. Instead, they are rotating all the time and brake is applied. So this way, effective braking is applied and the vehicle is come to stop. So this is a system, and then later we are going to other page of the schematic. This schematic is not completed in one page. Instead, it is coming to the second page. In the second page, you can see the first thing is hot and on or start, and here is another fuse which is meter fuse, and this meter fuse is why, because you know here a lamp is given and the other side of the lamp, the lamp will see its ground in the ABS module or electronic brake control module ABCM, which is written over here as you can see. So this is the module which you saw, or the computer, the ABS computer, which is controlling all the features, and also it is taking inputs and it is providing output to the actuators. So then this ABS indicator lamp, this is showing that the status of the ABS computer, how it is. I mean, if the computer is good, everything is okay, ABS is okay, so the lamp will not be there in the running, but in starting, first time while you are switching on the key, this light will come for a second and then this will disappear while the vehicle will be started, because this is showing the health of the computer as well as the health of the lamp. So this is, and then later here another thing which is coming is hot at all the time. This power is provided by this fuse, and there is a brake switch. This is the brake switch, you know, in the handbrake as well as in the pedal brake. This is, and it is showing, it is giving the position of the brake input to the module. It is telling that the driver is applying to brake, so the module should work and should stop the vehicle. So this is, and also this information is giving, this brake information is giving to the automatic transmission control and cruise control also, and brake lights also, I mean to say the rear brake lights, this is telling, and shift lock system. So this this splice is supplying power, I mean to say the signal also to there. And then here other things you can see, this is the shift on fly, shift on the fly system. This is cruise control, and this also, this is given as input to the brake module, ABS brake module. And here is another thing which is brake fluid level input. This is given to one switch, and then the switch other side is grounded over here, and some splice is also giving another ground to this one. So this while there will be fluid in the system, the switch will be opened, and this is a small reed switch which is attracted by a magnet, and that magnet is in the fluid. So while the fluid level in the reservoir is okay, so this switch will be opened, and if the fluid level is low, so it will be closed, and it will also turn on this lamp that the fluid level is not okay and the brake will not work. So due to any reason, if the ABS brake is not working, you will be shifted to the ordinary braking. This is a good feature of ABS, because sometimes ABS components are going bad or anything could happen, or some fuses are blown or something is happening. So by that way, you will be shifted to the ordinary braking system. This is the feature in all cars it is provided. And then later you can see here another sensor, which is the rear speed sensor. These are sometimes two and sometimes one, as in this case one has been shown. In some vehicle they are providing one, and some vehicle they are providing two separate sensors to all two wheels, to both two wheels. So this is the system. Hopefully the people who are working on automotive, especially automotive electrical, and who are working for ABS systems or whatever EFI cars they are working, this demonstration and this all detail will be helpful for them. I hope that you people will like this video and also will subscribe on my channel, so then you will get notifications for each upload. Thank you for watching. Give a big thumbs up and subscribe on my channel. Thanks for watching.